In this video, I'm going to show you how to install WordPress on Bluehost. Bluehost is a popular choice. It's widely recommended, and it's even one of the top recommended hosting companies on WordPress.org. So it's a solid choice for your hosting. Bluehost is also a great choice for beginners because they offer lots of additional support options to help you get started. What's awesome about this video is that I'm going to show you how to get a free Bluehost SSL certificate for WordPress and a free domain name. You'll also find this method of installing WordPress is much faster and easier to manage than the standard Bluehost hosting plans. After we install WordPress, I'll show you how to configure and set up WordPress so that your website can be off to an excellent start. It's really important to make sure that you have WordPress configured properly before you start building your website. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building websites. I provide free tutorials and reviews to help you get started making your own website. To get started with this tutorial on how to install WordPress on Bluehost, you're going to want to use the link below this video. It's a little bit confusing on the Bluehost website which is the best service to sign up for, so using the link below will ensure that you sign up for their WordPress hosting plan and that you get the free SSL certificate as well as the easiest way to install WordPress that Bluehost has to offer. Using the link below also will make sure that you're able to follow along with this video, because the other hosting plans that Bluehost offers have a more complicated setup process for WordPress. The link below is an affiliate link and it will cost you nothing extra. And actually, if there's any discounts that I can include, I'll include them with the link. This link also provides me with a little bit of a commission that helps me to make free tutorials like this one, as well as the free How to Build a Website Complete course that I offer on YouTube and on my website. And if you're interested in that, I'll link to that at the end of this video and in the description below. So let's dive in and learn how to install WordPress on Bluehost. Okay, so after you've clicked on that link below the video, I'm going to be taking you to this page right here. And this page here is a special page just for WordPress users. You can see here it says special offer for WordPress users. And you definitely get some benefits by clicking on that link. You're going to get a free domain name, free SSL certificate, which is something you absolutely need now. Google has basically said that they're going to be adjusting how they look at websites, and especially for like the Chrome browser is going to start giving warnings if you don't have an SSL certificate. So usually that's something you have to pay for, but here Bluehost is giving it to you for free if you use that link down below. And then we're also going to be able to install WordPress really easily. So let's go ahead and get started. And so to get started, you just click on the Get Started Now right here. And then you're going to choose a plan. So if you're just building one website, just going for the $3.95 a month plan is probably the best thing to do. If you're going to be building, multiple smaller websites or multiple websites, you might want to step up to the Plus. I definitely do think that with the Plus and the Premier, getting like the spam experts and the domain privacy is something I'm kind of a big fan of. What happens when you register a domain name is that there's a public record of who registered that domain name. So it's going to have your name, your address, your phone number, I believe, and your email address. You might think to yourself, you don't really care who knows that you own this website, but I'll tell you what the problem is if you don't have domain privacy, and it's something that happened when I was doing another one of these videos showing you guys how to set up WordPress, is that I didn't get domain privacy, and within a matter of like almost no time at all, it seemed like I was getting junk mail in my mailbox, I was getting email spam, I was getting phone calls about, just junk phone calls, robo phone calls. And so for me, paying a little bit extra to get the domain privacy is definitely worth it. Yeah, so I'm definitely going to go with the domain privacy. And I think the spam experts is something that's worth having just for the security of your website. But definitely there's no problem at all if you just select the basic plan. So those are the things to keep in mind. Since I'm just showing you guys how to do this, I'm not actually going to be using this account probably. I'm just going to go ahead and sign up for the base basic account here. But you might want to consider those other two things. So I'm going to go ahead and get a new domain. It is free with Bluehost with that link, so it's definitely worth doing. And it's pretty easy to get a new domain name. So this is a domain name I'm going to sign up for here. I'm going to just click on Next. Okay, and then all you need to do is just create your account. So you're going to fill in your name, address, sort of just all the usual stuff, the package information that you want. And then down here, you get some options here. Domain privacy protection for $9.90 a month. I'm definitely, even though I'm just showing you guys how to do that, I'm definitely going to click on that because I don't want to have any issues with that. It's always a good idea to have a great backup of your website. So it's something probably worth doing, especially as you're building your website. You might need to go back and change some things or undo some things, something worth having. There are other ways of getting a site backup. For example, if you get the pro version of Jetpack, you can get a site backup, and I think that's actually maybe a little bit cheaper. But having it through your hosting company oftentimes just sort of eliminates any confusion. So I think if you want these two things here, you should probably actually just sign up for that Premier account there. So I'm going to uncheck this because I don't need that right now for this website. I'm definitely going to do the domain privacy protection, and I'm not going to need the Site Backup Pro because I'm not really building a website on this. I'm just showing you guys how to sign up and set up your account, but it's something you might want to consider getting. And then one other thing to note here when you're signing up for hosting with Bluehost is that to get the maximum deal, the best deal that you can get, you do need to sign up for 3 years of hosting. I mean, it is one of the better deals, and if you're committed to making a great website, it's going to take you some time to get sort of the ball rolling and get things going. So definitely sort of locking in a low price is a good idea. But if you want to sign up for a smaller amount of time, you can do that. It's going to cost you a little bit more, but I think the overall the cost will be less. So that's something to keep in mind. Yeah, so just go ahead and fill out your information below, and then we'll go on to the next step. Okay, so then after you've signed up for your account, you'll be taken to this place here. Got the option of signing up for some WordPress help, some other things. I don't think you're really going to need those. It's always something you can add later on. So just click on No Thanks. Okay, and the next thing you need to do is you just need to create a password for the new account that you created. Definitely recommend using some sort of password management system. I personally use LastPass. I don't think it matters too much which one you use. I like LastPass, but there's other ones like 1Password. When you're building your website, you're going to be making a lot of different new accounts. And part of the thing is for your security, for your website security, you want to be using a different password for every website. That way, if the website gets hacked, and it happens, unfortunately, all the time that these big companies, their websites get hacked, they're not going to have access to all of your accounts. They're just going to have access to that one account. So you definitely want to make sure you create a secure password. So I'm going to do that right now. I'm just going to use LastPass to generate a password for me. I'm going to click on agree to that. And then I'm just going to go ahead and click on login. Okay, so now here, Bluehost is giving you some options for themes that you can pick. I've got like sort of a very specific theme that I like to use for WordPress, and I just think that it makes it easier to build your website. It's really flexible. A lot of themes that are out there, you know, they look great in these demos like this, but when it comes down to actually changing and modifying things, even like some of the most basic things like colors can be a headache to change, layouts and things like that. So my recommendation right now is the Divi theme. If you want to find out about Divi theme, I've actually got a full tutorial that'll show you how to set up the Divi theme and build a website with it. I just think it's easier because it's so flexible, it's easy to use, it's responsive, and it just does a lot of great things. So I would personally just skip all of these and, you know, check out my course or, you know, just check out the Divi theme. I've got a review of it. I'll link to the review at the top of the screen. And I'll link to the review in the description below and at the end of this video. And I've also got a free course where I'll show you guys exactly how to build a website and set it up. And I'm constantly making new tutorials to show you guys how to make different kinds of pages with the Divi theme. So definitely think that's worth checking out. So I'd go ahead and skip this step. And what I love about using that link that I provided below is that it just starts installing WordPress. You don't have to go to the cPanel. You don't have to mess up with a lot of the sort of things that really make hosting complicated. It just does it for you. Bluehost has made this like a really streamlined process for people who want to use WordPress, and it saves you time. It saves you headaches. It saves you like being really confused by the back end of what most hosting companies offer, or the cPanel, or even like the standard Bluehost setup. So definitely using this link is going to save you some time and make it a lot easier. Now, as you see up here, it says, for your information, we're provisioning your WordPress installation on a temporary domain. We'll set up your WordPress website to whatever the domain name that you created was automatically as soon as it's ready. But what they're going to do right now is they're going to make a temporary place where you can start working on your website. And so we're going to go ahead and we're going to do that right now. And I'm going to show you guys how to set up and configure WordPress. So, but to actually start working on your website with your domain, you might need to wait some amount of time. It's hard to say exactly how much. There's lots of variables in that. What happens when you register a new domain is that it needs to propagate across the internet and get connected with all the domain name servers before it can start using it. So what Bluehost has done here is they're allowing you to start working on your website until that domain gets ready. And then when that domain gets ready, you can start using your website with your domain name. But for now, we're going to use this temporary domain name that Bluehost has provided us to start building our website with. And so now we've installed WordPress on Bluehost, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to set up WordPress. And now they've got this sort of wizard that you can use to help you configure WordPress and get started. I'm just going to skip it because I'm going to show you guys exactly what you need to do. So just click on I don't need help. And these are some sort of Bluehost specific items, something you can use if you want. I don't personally use this. I've got my own method to do. But we're just going to go down the list here. I'm going to show you guys some things. One thing is Jetpack. It's something I actually only started using recently. It just sort of, you know, I like to keep my websites as simple as possible and not have too much extra stuff on my website, but it's definitely something I recommend that you use. And just the free version, what it does is it gives you easy to read site statistics, which is a great thing, because just knowing, you know, where people are coming onto your website, what pages they're looking at, and Jetpack makes it really easy to do that. You can also use Google Analytics, and there's a bunch of other services, but I find them to be a little bit confusing and complicated, and it's not something you need right when you get started. So Jetpack, the free version, definitely worth doing. You can create an account for free. And then under posts, there's always a default post, and I like to keep my websites as clean as possible, as I've said, so just go ahead and trash that. The default post is definitely a place where spam is going to start showing up, so when we get rid of that. Okay, so then from the posts, we're going to go over here to the pages, and there's some really important stuff coming up, just sort of getting the basic stuff out of the way. So we're going to trash the sample page because we don't need that. We're going to make our own pages. Comments. Usually there would be a comment in here because it would be under the post, but since we trashed the post, it also trashed comments. And the next thing here is under settings. So settings, we want to create a site title. You don't want your site to be called Welcome. You want it to be called whatever the name is of your website or whatever the main, you know, whatever your business name is. I'm going to call this Real Website Templates, and then a tagline for your website, so it's a little bit more of a description about what your website might be about. Okay, and then here we've got the WordPress URL and WordPress site address. Do not mess with those. Once your domain name gets set up, it should automatically change this over. If you mess with this, it can break your website. And if, for some reason, after your domain name is live and active, and again, that might take up to 24 hours, if it doesn't change here, you might need to call Bluehost support, but I'm pretty sure that they're going to make this automatically change for you. So just don't worry about that. Leave that alone. Don't touch it, because you're going to mess up your website. Here for the email address, you're going to want to add an email address that you have access to. So since you probably haven't set up email for your domain name, just make it in, you know, your default email address that you actually get mail to now. And this is going to give you information about new comments on your website and anything else that your website needs to communicate with you. It's going to be through this email address. So it's really important that you have access to that email address now. And the rest of these settings are fine. The one thing you might want to change here is the date format. Depending on where you are, you might be used to a different type of format. And then, of course, the time format, which day the week starts on. I like it to start on Sunday. And then up here, we've got the time zone. So just sort of wherever you are, if you scroll up farther on this, you can start getting to, you know, see cities. So I'm going to scroll up here. Normally in the Los Angeles area. Right now I'm on the East Coast, so I'm going to set it to the New York time zone. And then really important, whenever you make changes in WordPress, you want to scroll all the way down to the bottom, and you want to click on Save Changes. Okay, then we're going to go into writing here. If you want to create, later on you're going to be creating post categories. So if you want to change what the default category is, so instead of uncategorized, it's got whatever the default subject is for your site. You can change that here. Nothing else we need to worry about here. And then under reading, nothing you really need to change here. One thing you want to make sure is that we've got this box here, which is discourage search engines from indexing the site. Right now, the default position is where you want it, which is unchecked. So what this is going to do is it's going to sort of, if you check this box, it's going to discourage search engines from indexing your site. So if you don't want your site to be found, it's going to help that. Basically, there's no way to stop search engines from indexing your site. But if you click that box, it will ask them not to. And they probably will anyways, but it asks them not to. But basically, if you want to make sure your website's being found, you want to make sure that's unchecked. So that's really important. By default, it is, but just something to double check. And then the last thing, and the really probably the most important setting here, is the permalinks. The default is sort of this date, name, and then post name. But really what you want to have is is have it set to post name here. So we're going to click on post name, and what that's going to do is give what they call a pretty link. Once your domain name is all set up, it's going to have your URL here and then just slash the name of your post. And that's going to make it easier for search engines to understand what your pages and posts are about. And it's going to make it easier for you to share your content because you're going to be able to have an easier to read link to the different pages on your website. So definitely click on that. Don't forget to click Save Changes. And now let's go ahead and look at the plugins. And I like to just get rid of any extra plugins that I don't think that we're going to need. Just click on plugins and then scroll down here. So the Acumen is definitely something I recommend having. You can get your API key for that. I believe it's the same API key as you use for Jetpack if you signed up for that, but I'm not sure on that. And that's something that you do need to step up to the next level of the Jetpack service to get. So I'd leave that alone. The Hello Dolly thing, it doesn't really do anything, so just go ahead and delete that. So Jetpack, definitely something I would leave on there and use. Mojo Marketplace is not something I use because I've got my own recommendations for themes and plugins for your website. So if you want to, you can leave it on there if you think you're interested in the themes and plugins that they might offer. I don't use it, so I'm going to get rid of it. So to do that, you just click on deactivate. And then it deactivates the theme, and then you've got the option to delete it. If you use Optin Monster, you can leave this on there. I don't use it, so I'm just going to deactivate it and delete it. And the WP Forms Lite is something you might want to use. It sort of makes it easier to make contact forms for your website. The Divi theme that I recommend actually has its own contact form builder built into it, so I like to use that. So I'm going to also deactivate this, but it's something that you might be interested in if you're using a different theme. Okay, so there we go. So now I've showed you how to install WordPress on Bluehost. I've showed you how to set up and configure WordPress. And we've got everything ready to start building our site. So if you want to continue along with me and you want to see how to install a WordPress theme and a theme that I really like, which is the Divi theme, and see how to like start building your website with WordPress and the Divi theme, check out the link at the end of this video, and I'll link to you my free tutorial series that will show you how to do that. And if you want to find out more about building your website and you want to find more free tutorials, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and visit me at realwebsitehints.com. Thanks for watching.